All right, everyone, I showed you this once before, but I'm gonna show you again because there's a very important piece of information you need to have if you're gonna do this to your bike. So let me show you what I'm talking about. All right, well, look at this giant cast of characters here. So what I wanna show you is the mirrors. Everybody asks me about mirrors all the time, and I put mirrors on almost all of my bikes. Here's the mistress bike. She's got these mirrors on her. And the wifey's little red mini step through has the mirrors on it as well. Kid seat on there, we'll get to that. That's a whole other video coming. The Bike Tricks bike has round mirrors on it. Same basic kind of mirrors though. I'm all about the bar end mirrors. I tried all kinds of different mirror setups. Bar end mirrors have by far worked the best. They get out around your shoulders. They're the easiest to see what's going on the side of you and behind you. So maybe it's because I'm a motorcyclist that I find myself looking for mirrors all the time on these bikes. So I put them on almost every bike, and you can see I ride this bike enough that it's time. It's time to graduate to getting some side view mirrors here on the skate bike. We're gonna cut them in. You can see the faux leather wrap goes all the way around. There's no cap in the bar end here. So you gotta remove a hole out of there so you can put the bar end mirror in there. And let me show you what they look like. I buy these kind right here. I will link them in the description. But here is the very, very important piece of information that I need to tell you, and it's that right there. If you're gonna buy these mirrors, make sure you get this, the rubber insert that goes inside the bar. The last time I did this video, I linked the mirrors, and then the company went and changed the product, and they made this thing aluminum, and they just didn't work, and they don't fit. So you gotta make sure when you order bar end mirrors, you get this rubber insert. So as you tighten it up right here, it goes inside the handlebar and that rubber expands and it makes it tight so it doesn't fall out. But the rubber ones work the best, so you got to get those. I don't care what brand you buy, I'll link this so you know which one I bought, but buy whatever one you want, just make sure it comes with that type of insert that goes in the handlebar. All right, so now you know which kind of mirrors to buy. Let me show you the special tool that you need to install them, and that is right here, this cheap metal broomstick. This is how you cut a hole in the end of the wrap right here. You just twist it and it'll cut a nice little hole in the end of the bar there for you to slide the mirror thing in, and you're good to go. So I'm gonna do that now. I'm gonna cut some holes in the end so we can get mirrors on this bike. And you can set these up however you want. I always set them so the mirror comes up over top of my hand, but you could flip it the other way if you wanted and have the mirror going, you know, out here instead. But I don't like that because then you're making the bike a whole lot more wide. You know, it's, you're making it like probably 8 inches wider. I don't want the bike any wider. I want to be able to still fit through narrow stuff. So I always have the mirrors going up over my hand. They do not get in the way at all as far as like working the brakes or anything. So no issues with that. So I almost always tilt them that direction. These are like identical. These are two different brands. So there's a whole bunch of brands that use the same exact design. They're heavy, they're metal. I like these ones. I don't like the ones with the plastic that go inside the bar, because if I ever knock the bike over or I wreck the bike, which I've done both before, I've knocked these bikes over, and how many times, and I've wrecked the mistress bike going like 10, 15 miles an hour, and this mirror took a full force hit on the pavement and didn't, it just got dirty, that was it. So these things are very strong. I like the metal ones. So let's get these on the escape bike and give her a much needed upgrade. All right, well, upgrade is complete. We now have side and rear view vision on this bike with these bar end mirrors. And the next very important thing that I gotta tell you is that these are gonna loosen up. You better believe it, they're gonna get loose. I'll ride this, I tightened them down as tight as it'll go, but I usually ride it once, they'll loosen up. I tighten them down as hard as I can. I'll ride another time or two, they'll loosen up. I tighten them down as hard as I can. You gotta do that about 3 or 4 times of just cranking them down as tight as you can get them before they just stay completely put, and then you never really have to touch them again. So just know that they're gonna loosen up on you, and you're gonna have to just re-tighten them probably 3 to 4 times. Now, I use the broomstick to cut the hole in the end. I've heard other people say you can just whack the end of the bar with a mallet and the, you know, the bar will cut through the leather itself. I usually use this actually as a bit of a motivator to get the thing started into the handlebars. sometimes you gotta trim that rubber piece down slightly, make it a, you know, not such a flat end on it, kind of make it a cone shape so it'll start sliding in the bar. And then I usually whack it with a mallet a few times to get it in there nice and snug. There you have it, bar end mirrors, probably one of my favorite accessories for e-bikes. I couldn't live without them personally. I put them on, like I said, almost every bike. Try them, I guarantee you'll like them. Go buy a set with the rubber inserts, you gotta remember that. And any shape will do, really. And the round ones kind of aren't my favorite. I like these longer ones because I kind of tilt them up and it gives me just a little bit better view having the longer mirror. It's like 4 inches long, I think, so good visibility on the sides and behind you. So check them out. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.